Don't be in denial. You have to actually be aware that there is something wrong because your clothes are getting tighter day by day. So right. That is the first realization.
Right, right.
So your wardrobe size is changing.
Right.
That should be the first tinkle in your mind.
True.
And if that happens, you have to start thinking about working on it.
Welcome back again to Fit Friday with KJ, and we are in conversation with Dr. Samir again. Sir, our first part of this interview was actually a lot of content was given to us with regards to educate the people of Vadodara and even me as to what actually obesity is. We talk about the obesity surgery again, sir. What are the risks involved with obesity surgery? How much time does it take for a person to recover it? And how open should the person be to, I mean, to actually get down under the operation table and start doing it?
Okay. First of all, the patient has to fall under one of the guidelines for surgery.
Right.
So once the patient decides to undergo surgery, patient is basically now it's done laparoscopically.
Right.
So no cutting open entirely, that was done 30 years back.
Okay.
So now it's done with keyhole surgery, which is quite common, you know, gallbladder surgeries, appendix, hernias, hysterectomies, they're all done laparoscopically now commonly.
Okay.
So obesity has also become part of a routine surgery program.
Okay.
And patient needs to be in the hospital for 5 days.
Just 5 days?
Just 5 days.
Okay.
Max. That's the max I'm talking about.
Okay.
Majority of the patients are discharged on the third or the fourth day.
Excellent. Okay.
Right? And there are a few, because obesity surgery, it's not about the surgery, it's about the patient.
Right.
Obese patient is a high-risk patient.
Right.
Right? From the anesthetic point of view, from the surgical point of view.
True.
So there are so many issues in an obese patient because these patients are metabolically very fragile.
Right. Right.
Right? So we need to first, preoperatively, we correct all the metabolic problems as far as possible. All deficiencies are corrected preoperatively. There are certain exercises that we recommend preoperatively at home because they cannot go to the, most of them cannot go to the gym when they come to us.
Right.
Because they've already had some knee problem, some back problem. So, metabolically very fragile patients, they need some extra care.
Right,
from the surgeon, from the anesthetist, from the dietitian, technology wise, they need to be operated in an ideal surgical setup.
It's a complete holistic
effort. Yeah, yeah, it's a team. Basically,
okay.
It's a team.
Okay,
right.
Sir, rehab mate vaad kara mate. I mean, this is where my next question was. Ki main eva bahu badha loko joya chhe ki they undergo an obesity surgery, and pachhi loko koi workout nahi karta. They don't start training, they don't start taking care of their body, and they tend to have a lot of loose skin because of whatever calorie deficit has happened because of the surgery. How strongly do you advise these patients to get disciplined with their trainings?
Yeah, it's very strongly recommended that they, at least for, say, for the first month, they might not be able to go to the rehab center. But as soon as they start feeling good, start feeling energetic,
right.
And this all happens on the second month,
okay.
Right? Second to third month. They just feel so energetic because they have an unlimited source of energy from their fat cells.
Yes, absolutely. Yes.
Right?
Yes.
So that energy problem that is normally there in a pre-operative patient is not there in post-op patient. So these are the patients who need to be in a very properly framed protocol-based rehab program.
Okay.
Then and then only, you know, we cannot just randomly advise, oh, you can do this, you can do this. You have to do this in the second month, you have to do this in the third month, you have to do this in the fourth month. So we have to give them specific achievable targets.
with intensity changing and growing and progressively over the period of time.
Right? We have to have that specifically achievable targets.
Right.
That's the word I would use.
Do you have a kind of a program that there is a gestation period in which the client who comes to you has or moves or gets into a position where he can do something good for himself without being in surgery?
Yeah, we have a medically supervised weight loss program. This is one of its kind in the state of Gujarat.
Okay.
I haven't seen anybody running that program anywhere in the state. Right. I don't know about the country, but I have a very specifically designed program for my patients.
Okay.
So, most of my patients, I explain to them what is the program about. There's a 10-page consent.
Okay.
Which I have devised it myself.
Okay.
And everything is mentioned in that.
True.
Patient has to read through it and sign it before joining the program.
True.
It's a very scientifically and evidence-based practice.
Okay.
This is a very new thing in our field of medicine.
Okay.
That whatever evidence that we have to incorporate in our practice.
True.
Right. So that is how we keep on upgrading our practice on a day-to-day basis.
True.
So these patients are put on it's a 6-month program.
All right.
And in 6 months, we train the patient how to eat differently.
Okay.
Right. And initially for 1 month, we ask them to stop going to any kind of aggressive sports activity.
Okay.
Or aggressive gymming.
Okay.
They can go to a normal routine walk or treadmill or something like that. But no excessive workouts for 1 month.
True.
Once they have changed their diet, right? Once they start becoming healthy,
right?
They can go back to their routine workouts that they were enjoying.
Right.
So to lose weight, the exercises are different. To stay healthy and fit, the exercises are different.
Right.
So if somebody is able to identify that, then it works wonderfully for the patient.
Sir, aaj aapne lakh rupaye ki baat kari, I would say that. Woh motu myth panch hai lokra magaj mein. People look, I mean, say for instance, I'm doing a squat or I'm doing a bench press with some 100 kgs on weight. When that is seen by an obese person or a person who really wants to, and should be at the gym, jare ye vastu hai, jare joy chhe na ki yaa, to ina ek magaj mein ek aath hai jai chhe ki bas, maari to aath thawarun na thi. It is not something that I can do, but they don't really come, do that effort of coming to a gym because that is not meant for them at this stage. At a later stage, yes, squatting is the most, it's the best exercise you can do with your body. There's no doubt about that. But this particular education needs to be provided to these people.
Yeah.
Sir, what is your fitness mantra? I mean, how do you keep yourself so fit and pink, I would say?
So I'll tell you my personal health problems. My nutrition journey began way back in I just entered college.
Okay.
I was exposed to medical knowledge.
Right.
So there were certain myths, certain guidelines during that time. And I followed those guidelines for almost 17, 18 years.
Okay.
Right. Thinking that that is right. So then I was on medication. You know, my physician friends, cardiology friends, I, of course, visited them, took their advice, started taking medication. But my problems, and along with that, I had a lot of GI issues.
True.
GERD, the reflux, IBS symptoms.
Mm-hmm.
But then a doctor friend of mine exposed me to a new way of eating.
Right.
And then I ventured into it, did research for almost 1 year.
Okay.
Went through all the literature. I'm still... That research is still ongoing.
True.
And I completely revamped my health.
Okay.
Right? I got rid of my hyperinsulinic problem. My pre-diabetic status has gone. My cholesterol and triglycerides are below normal.
Okay.
Right? The upper limit of normal.
Right.
And I'm full of energy.
Sir, on the same platform that we're talking about, what is your suggestion as a doctor who deals with obesity to citizens of Vadodara, how they should take care of themselves and how important is workout to keep themselves healthy?
See, first of all, one has to realize that there is some weight problem.
Right.
So that is the most important thing.
Don't stay in denial.
Yeah, don't be in denial. You have to actually be aware that there is something wrong because your clothes are getting tighter day by day. So right. That is the first realization.
Right, right.
So your wardrobe size is changing.
Right.
That should be the first tinkle in your mind.
True.
And if that happens, you have to start thinking about working on it. So best way is to go to somebody who deals with such patients. So an obesity specialist, and take his professional advice. Get the necessary investigations done.
True.
Right. And try and join a fitness program.
True, true.
That is definitely going to help in the early stages.
Right.
For prevention.
True.
Right. And when you join a fitness program, you automatically stop eating the wrong food.
Yes, yes.
Right?
You become conscious.
You become conscious.
True.
So, staying fit and healthy at a very early stage of your problem.
Right.
Not early age, but early stage of your problem. So, when you realize that your wardrobe size is changing, take help. So and that is the best thing to do.
Again, thank you so much for having us and your hospital. You need any information with obesity and you have any questions, Dr. Samir is at Vigos at Jetalpur Road. And we will come next with better episodes with more information and a whole lot to talk about fitness. Till then, stay fit and be awesome. Cheers.